Vladimir, and I continue my exercise, walking and talking. In this video, I'm going to talk about Speaking Club. Speaking Club usually takes place in this building, in Kaluga. We are gathering up on Sunday and discuss some different topics. And, well, also we get there on Saturday and discuss, watch a lecture, and then discuss it for like an hour. We watch it and an hour we discuss it. And so now in this video I'm going to, you know, to explain you why I'm doing this, why I working on this speaking club, and what I want to achieve, what my purpose. And an interesting point is that I don't know exactly what I'm going to say next, because, well, I try to think about it a lot, like since I started conducting the speaking club in this place. It was first speaking club I made in the March of this year, like 9 months ago. And well, after that I asked myself like every week, and sometimes it wasn't only just every week, like last time it becomes more and more important for me. And before I started working on the speaking club here in this place, I haven't had this strong motivation. I mean, I was studying English and I was learning, I was reading books and do all my exercises, like self-talk and writing, journal, and I watched lots of videos. But my motivation, like why was somewhere else. I mean, it wasn't too important for me to, you know, to attract lots of people at the speaking club and make them happy, and, you know, to prepare some topics. I didn't care about it at all. And as I said before I started, actually haven't said that, but now I'll say it. So before I started conducting speaking club here in this place, I was working on another speaking club. It's like it was the same speaking club, but I was sitting in a different place. I mean, the place was different, and it was a cafe in center. And well, in this cafe there only a few people came, like quite rare. So, and sometimes I was sitting alone. I mean, few months, there was years when few months nobody came, but I still was working on it. I had an article, not article, but a page or a blog on the internet, and I was writing, I was, you know, asking people like coming to the speaking club. And when it was different place, it didn't work well, and my level wasn't good. I mean, when I started doing this in 2017, my level of English was awful. I couldn't talk well. I had a terrible accent. I now have it as well, but it's much better, and especially when I talk at speaking club. I know there's a slight differences between what I'm like, how I'm talking right now, and how I'm talking at speaking club, because when I have some prepared materials, I, you know, and when there's no such pressure, I mean, now there's little pressure, because it's like it's an unusual situation, and I'm going in the street and talking to myself. But okay, let's. I don't want to talk about grammar and and the pronunciation and all this stuff. It's like enough. As I said, I had this speaking club in different place, and when I started, and I didn't care about it too much. But when I moved to Innovational Cultural Center, I started thinking about it more, and I started working on this club a little bit, like in a different way. And of course, it made me a kind of different person, because lots of stuff which I did for myself, now I don't do them because I just invest more time in making the speaking club better. So I'm really I prepare topics, I work on different subjects, and I'm trying to think a lot about how to make it better. Whereas before I haven't thought about it too much, or I hadn't thought about it too much, yeah. I've mostly thought about, you know, the information and the experience which I had. And now it bothers me a little bit, because I know that, like, it's important, but I don't want to become a slave of this club. Even if it's my club, I mean, I don't want to be completely overwhelmed by working on this club and miss anything else. Because another thing which I'm doing is like recording, for example, these videos. And quite recently I started walking and talking, and yeah, it changed my perspective a little bit. And now I'm thinking about focusing on this work more seriously. And I really like it. I mean, I like it even more than speaking club, because speaking club gets me, you know, almost nothing. I mean, it gets me an opportunity to express myself, it gets me the opportunity to like try managing other people, work with them, try to organize stuff. It's like a kind of some professional skills for, you know, I can use them, I can apply them for a variety of purposes, but it's not what I really want and not what I need, because I'm not gonna work as a, you know, as a manager or something like that. Yeah, and I did it. And I did it mostly for myself, because, as I said, I had a need to practice my English, and the best thing which I could do at that moment was just to invite people who practice English and just start talk with them. And speaking club was a solution for that. And I think, like, everybody, because, like, if you have to learn English and you need to, you know, somehow you need to improve your social skills, you can make your own speaking club pretty easy. I mean, it doesn't take a lot of you know, effort. Hey, it takes some effort, but I mean, it depends on what you want to get. If you want to get just a few people with whom you can communicate in English, you can just start from zero, from scratch. You can just make a page on Wiki, invite a few people and say, okay, let's gather once a week and try to talk in English. Even if you don't know English, I mean, you may start from zero. If you have friends, for example, who are interested in studying English and they also don't know English, you may just like invite them for, you know, for speaking club and start communicating with them in English and start, you know, to learn something together. Because, you know, in school, for example, we learn something that teachers tell us to learn. But now it's like it's all outdated. You can learn everything you want and just use other people who, not use, but just organize them, for example, who have the same needs. And it's not only about speaking clubs. What's time? Well, 9 minutes only. I have 5 more. So it's not only about speaking clubs, it's about, you know, everything you like to do in life. For example, if you like, you know, dancing or martial arts, for example, you can just find people who also like to do that, and you can, you know, create some sort of environment for practicing these skills. And it's not too difficult. You can practice them alone if you prefer. But for the speaking club gives you opportunity to really to immerse yourself into studying, because otherwise you probably won't have a serious motivation for learning. Because for me, when I started making this speaking club, I got too much motivation. I mean, literally too much. Before I studied English like few hours a day, and there were some improvements. There were times when I was able to study like 5 hours or 6 hours. And by study, of course, I don't mean study. Like when I started understanding language in 2016, I just watched videos which I liked to watch, and I read books which I liked to, which I liked to read. But at that time, reading was really hard. I could read only a few pages a day, and without understanding like 50% of what I was reading, or even more than 50. Reading was hard, but watching videos was much easier, and I was able to watch like few hours, you know, any content, different videos every day. And but it still wasn't, no, I hadn't such strong motivation. But when I started working on speaking club, when I just, okay, now I'm a leader of dance speaking club and I need to, you know, prepare topics and work on it, it made me a totally different person, and I started learning like English all day long, like non-stop, literally non-stop. I don't learn only if like I feel exhausted, and it doesn't happen like for months. Sometimes, of course, I can feel exhausted, like after, for example, a few months of serious work, when I read books. Like now, I'm reading The Principles of Mathematics by Bertrand Russell, and it's hard. I'm still reading like a few hours a day. I'm trying to, you know, I decided to read it at the end of November. It was my goal to read this book. And it requires like 2 hours of reading every day, approximately 20-30 pages. And so I'm read almost half of the book. Now I'm on the page 200, and there's like 300 pages more. And I'll finish this book at the end of the month, I'm sure. But yeah, it takes, like when I set serious goals, like reading certain books, especially books which I don't understand well, or watching some lectures, and again, especially lectures which I don't understand well. When I watch some, let's say, behavioral biology, for example, by Robert Sapolsky, it's difficult to watch. And when I set a goal to watch all these lectures for like 25 days, because there are 25 lectures, and usually I set goal like to watch one lecture a day to understand, sometimes two lectures a day. Well, when I set such goals, like I can be exhausted, but in general what I'm doing, it doesn't, like I don't feel tiredness, I don't feel weird, because it's really, it's easy for me. Now I have a lot of power, or no, we can say, I can call it mental power or psychological power, and this power allows me to work on English non-stop, think in English all the time, and develop my language, and I feel like really awesome. And well, coming back to speaking club, just a few minutes to finish this video. I was saying in the beginning that it will be about speaking club and blah 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 blah, but instead of talking about speaking club, I just started talking about something different, and that's okay. I'm talking what I think is important in this particular moment. If I can't focus on speaking club, probably it's just not important for me right now, because, well, I actually said something about that, and what I said, probably it was enough. Of course, I had some interesting thoughts before. For example, yesterday I was thinking, just if I start talking about speaking club, what I can say, like what exactly I can say about that, that can be useful for somebody who are maybe are members of our speaking club, or maybe somebody who wants to come to speaking club. Well, it wasn't like I hadn't intended to like to prompt you to come to speaking club, or to create your own speaking club and work on it. But suddenly, as I started talking, yeah, it was what came to my mind, and I didn't block it. Okay, seems that probably I'm already exhausted, because it's fourth speech. I'm talking like almost uninterruptedly for the whole hour, and it's not just talking. I'm going and I'm walking also. There's wild environment and people, and it makes me a little bit anxious. And I'm still trying to control, you know, trying to understand how I can use this. How I can use this technique to improve my English and to improve myself. Okay, for today I think for now it's enough, but probably I'll record one more video because I have something else to say, but I'll start a new one.